Well, Australian banks have announced a new anti-scam platform that will help fight fraudulent transactions faster.
A lot of it going around, isn't there? Cybersecurity expert Susan McLean joins us now from Melbourne. Susan, how does it all work? We need it.
Well, we absolutely need it. And I think for far too long, banks have been able to really run their own show about this and do what they want when they want. There's been no coordinated effort, if you like. And that was one of the big things when, if you perhaps moved money into one bank, and then the scammer was going to move it from that to another bank, it took weeks to coordinate that. The banks simply didn't talk to each other. They didn't share intelligence. And it was the poor customer that lost all the money.
And this is the thing. So many customers we're hearing about are losing the money, and there's a lot of frustration but also vulnerability out there. How much of an impact do you think this new program will have?
Well, it's probably a little bit too little too late. Mm. But, I mean, I'm always for giving praise when praise is due. It's a good improvement. So we move forward and we accept that they're doing something. But I think it should not be the victim of a crime who's responsible for sorting out the mess. Mm. And it's no use saying, oh, well, these people shouldn't have clicked on the link or shouldn't have sent money. We know scams are a thing. They've been around in different forms for a long time. I think it's beholden on banks to do their part of the deal and protect their users, the same as seatbelts protect people in cars. You know, it's not simply on the passenger or the driver of the car to be safe. The platform, if you like, should be doing more to protect us.
Well, that's, there was a story yesterday about a dude who clicked on a text message and lost 16 grand.
Yeah.
Some of this has got to come back to the banks for compensation, doesn't it? I mean, I don't understand how it's all our fault.
No, and that's the thing. It's victim blaming at its highest. Yeah. You know, you were stupid, you clicked on the link. Well, you don't need to tell me that because I realise that because I now have no money.
Yes.
So I think the banks have to do better.
Yeah.
And if through, and this means the telcos have to do better, and I know they've really improved in the blocking of some of these scam texts as well. But I remember my, this is like before the real scam things, my credit card got skimmed overseas. And I lost a truckload of money. And it was obviously what had happened because they took 10 cents, 10 cents, 10 cents, and then wiped me out. And I had to fight with the bank to get my money back.
This is it. I mean, this is the whole thing. And I want to say this too. They're really good at selling us insurance, at overpriced insurance that we never cash in on.
Yeah.
Why isn't there some kind of insurance? I mean, I guess there is with credit card, but God, it takes us 4 months to get money back from a bank when someone's ripped us off.
Yeah, look, they have to do better. I think the tide's turned. I think people now are starting to demand better. Mm. There is an expectation that, A, this won't happen or it'll be stopped, or if it does, the bank will support us and work with us. And I don't think we've seen that. Hopefully it will change now, that the victims of these crimes are going to be better supported and the money is not going to be siphoned offshore or into scammers' bank accounts. It's going to remain where it should.
I agree with that completely.
New age problem, but it demands new age solutions. All right, thanks so much.
She's got all the solutions.
Yeah, she does, doesn't she? Let's just all listen to Susan.
Just roll her out across the country. Good on you, Susan. Thank you.
Me now.